Hi, Sheila with BizWorth here. Thanks for joining me for today's case study on a video production and distribution company. Regardless of what business you own or industry you operate within, the fundamental tools and techniques of valuation are the same, and the BizWorth reports are structured in the same format regardless of what business you own. So today's case study can be very applicable for any business owner because a lot of what we're going to cover is not particularly necessarily specific to a video production company, but we are going to call out some specific information that video production and distribution companies can relate to most. With that being said, we take confidentiality extremely seriously here at BizWorth. We've changed the name of the company to something generic. We've changed the valuation amount. We've changed the buyout percentage. This particular case study was for a share redemption, a buyout of 10% of the shares that was owned by one of the owners of this company. Dates have been changed. Everything's been changed. There's nothing identifying to this company other than the industry in which it operates. So with that being said, let's jump out to the report. I'm going to walk through some high-level information and some specific information. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out to us here at BizWorth. Go to bizworth.com, schedule a free consultation. We'd be happy to talk about the business valuations and how a business valuation for your situation could be applied and how we go about our engagements. So don't hesitate to reach out. I hope you enjoy the case study and I hope it's helpful. So what I'm going to do is bring up a very particular case study. Like I said, we've changed the key information, but this is a BizWorth valuation report. It's certified. Everyone that conducts valuations here are certified professionals. And again, this was for a 10% buyback of shares, share redemption of a non-controlling and non-marketable interest. And for this particular valuation, it's important to know that we did have access, obviously, to all the company information, the financials, and our report was structured in a way the same as all reports. But a majority of the people, they can get everything they need to get out of the executive summary at a high level. So if you read the entire report, you need a quick refresher. The executive summary is very helpful. This is where we're going to focus the majority of our time today. There's also the introduction. This is very specific to the standard of value that's chosen for a particular engagement. There's also the nature and history of the company. This section is extremely important because it really covers what's specific to a company and all the great benefits and the earnings potential to that company is laid out here, the particulars of that business. The overview of the economy and industry. This is very important too, because you need to understand the economy, the industry in which the company operates. It also helps inform growth rates, just as an example. Financial condition and earnings potential. This is a key section of the report. We cover the financials of the company, but we also talk about how the company benchmarks to competitors within the same industry. And then we go into the valuation. And then there's quite a few appendices as well. So let's jump into, and we list lots of figures and tables. But going into the executive summary report, we lay it out. There's a conclusion of value for this particular company, $225,000 for 10% ownership interest. Again, we changed the valuation amount for this exact company that we're talking about. There's three standards of value for this share redemption, for the share buyback. Fair market value was the appropriate standard of value. It was a going concern. And here on the left, we start to talk about and summarize the nature and history of the business. This business had been in operations for 4 to 5 years. They had lots of great things going for the company. They had grown the company with substantial growth over a short period of time. One of the risks that stood out about this video production company, a lot of businesses can relate to, in producing their parody content in the videos and the commentary, which they distributed over multiple channels, including YouTube, Twitch, and some other popular mechanisms. They had quite a few subscribers. They had a huge subscriber base, strong following. But what was interesting is that there were a few key personalities that were a part of this content that they produced. That is one of the downsides, one of the risks. lots of companies can relate to this because there might be a key person, a key personality that the company identifies with. While the company is what it is because of that person or these individuals, it is a slight risk going forward. But on the flip side, there's lots of benefits. So usually the benefits well outweigh the risks because that's why the company's a going concern. They have a lot of good things going for the particular business. This particular business had a great distribution channel. They were very creative in their content. But another downside was that it had to continue to produce new content and new ideas. The economy in the industry in which this company operated in was important to highlight. It was important to understand the video production, the distribution, the entertainment industry in which it operated, and to understand those growth rates, because you need to understand the growth of a company can outpace that of the industry, but over the long run, it likely won't. So you need to understand the industry in which your business operates. That's very important. The financial condition and earnings potential of this particular company. This company is a service-based business. It's asset light. So when it's asset light, some of the key ratios may not be as applicable. But what's great about service-based businesses is that typically there's not a lot of overwhelming capital upfront that you have to put into your business. And when we do benchmarkings, we'll benchmark against other service-related businesses that are also light on the assets as well. So this particular company, revenues, we changed all the numbers, so they won't mean much, but the growth itself means a lot. High growth early on in the last 5 years, but it began to plateau when the company began to stabilize. So you'll see that that will likely inform the growth rates chosen for this particular company for the valuation. The valuation itself, because it was a service-based business, we did look at the asset, but it didn't really inform the valuation because there were so few assets on the book. So there isn't an asset approach. There are methods. But for this particular valuation, it really means a lot to hone in on the income approach and the market approach. The income approach for this particular company we chose because we felt as if the discount rate really properly reflected the risk of the company. Also, the growth rates we felt were company specific. So the income approach was much more representative of the valuation of the company, we felt. There were lots of good comparables found for this particular company. And you can see that the valuation for this company was very similar for market or for the income approach. Sometimes these values are a little bit more separated than what we're showing. Sometimes they're even closer. Some valuation companies choose to average the different valuations that are derived from the different methods. In this particular case, we chose to pick a very specific valuation based on one method. It's much more easier to explain how that valuation came up with as opposed to a weighted average or to an average. But both is done. We understand there's good circumstances why you might do either one. But for this particular company, we chose a particular valuation, a specific valuation based on the income approach. And the method we chose for this company was a multi-stage growth method. And this just means that we chose different growth rates for different times in the future expectations, the future horizon of this company. So for example, for the next 2 years, we may have chosen one growth rate. For the next 3 to 4 years, we chose another. And then for the remaining life of the company, we chose a growth rate that was more applicable to the economy, GDP, or the industry for that example. Just to give you a quick preview of the report itself, we go into the introduction. We talk about the standard of value, the premise of value. This is a going concern business. It was not winding down. It was not in bankruptcy. And then we talk about the valuation procedure that we chose. We talk about the nature and history of this company. There was so many great things going for this company. We talk about the products and services. We talked about the distribution channel, the particular videos in which this company did produce. Customers, competition is important. The management and personnel is very important. You want to understand how businesses run, the facilities, if there's facilities of a particular business. Then we go right into the overview of the economy and the industry. After speaking about the economy and the industry and the report we write up, we go straight into the financial condition, and the earnings potential of a business. And that's important. You want to understand the growth potential of a business. Examples that are important for this particular business might have been the facilities in which they were producing their video and their content. Was it sufficient? If they need to grow, do they need more facility space? Do they need more computers? Do they need more people? If you're in manufacturing, for example, do you need more manufacturing space? There might be some bottlenecks that we need to consider. Now, you can unlock those bottlenecks, but it may require more capital. And that's regardless of the business you're in. If you're wanting to produce more content, you may have to hire more videographers to do that, for example. Moving right in, once we go through the financial condition and earnings potential, we do benchmark against industry. That's very important to understand how the subject company is operating against its industry. The next section, we go right into the valuation, and we talk about the three approaches: the asset, the income, and the market. We talk about the methods that we choose, and we close it out from there. There's lots of appendices. We talk about the income statement, the balance sheet, and we benchmark those against industry. So I hope overall that this valuation was very helpful for you. If you're interested in more case studies, please visit our website, where we'll continue to update our website with more case studies. You're also welcome to subscribe to our YouTube channel. So if you found this helpful, the most helpful way that you can help us as a business is to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also, please go out to bizworth.com and schedule a free consultation if you have any questions about today's case study or how this applies to your business. And we'll look forward to you watching more case studies in the future. Thanks so much.